is a very old medieval way of degreasing the sword. It cleans it, removes any debris and grease from the blade, ready for re-oiling. In this case, I'm using it for a degrease to allow the clay I put on for the hardening process to stick very, very well to the sword. And this is the powder, and you mix a little bit of water to make a slurry, and then apply this to the sword, and then allow it to dry and wipe it off. The deer horn is made from red stag horn coming from Scotland, wild stag horn. It's very, very important it's wild, because the modern farm deer is not the horn hasn't got the minerals and other things in it which are necessary for the degrease. And grinding deer horn into powder is, as I can say, a lot of work. It's hard stuff to grind, but this pot I did about 3 years ago. It took me 3 days to make. 3 days to make degrease. Anyway, here it is, and you need like a slurry like this. Nicely pasted out. Don't have to be too accurate with it, as long as it's nice and smooth. Don't want lumps in it. This is the sword ready for hardening. It's been cleaned up to 400 grit, and is ready to receive the clay ready for hardening. You just smear it on the blade quite thickly. Make sure you get a good coating of it on the blade. My grandfather, who taught me this, or didn't teach me, I only met him three times, twice in the forge and once at the trooping of the colour. He told my father to do this. They used to do this to the cavalry sabres, to look after them and clean them. And it's kind of the symbolic death of a sword, covering it in this paste, and then when you remove it, it's the blade's rebirth for use. It's a nice thing. So we're kind of giving it its death shroud at the moment, and then when it's dry, we'll remove it. feel the how dry the sword gets. Sucks any kind of moisture off of the sword. And finally, I'll give it a wash. Try and get all the powder off. That's it, it's degreased. That's it. Crenellated hardness line on the cutting edge of the sword. This is just a nice thing to do if I we're going to attempt to do that for the sword, so it'll look nice when it's hardened. So I'm marking the areas where it'll step. Crenellations are what you see on a castle on the wall top when it goes steps up, steps down, steps up and steps down. I thought that was applicable to this sword.